impossible could not have happened. Whatever happened must have been that which is possible. Paimon bought them when we were reading at the bookshop in the city earlier. Pretty cool, huh? Don't worry, Paimon used her own savings to buy them. It wasn't from our travel funds.
I think they look cute on you, Paimon.
You have good taste, Lynette! Alright, let's go have a look while the investigation teams are still here. Detective Paimon is on the case! Right. And do you really need to do that if you're kidnapping them? Ugh, this is so confusing. Paimon doesn't want to be a detective anymore.
I mean, what better way to properly think through our findings than over some tea and sweets?
Huh. Breaking out suddenly doesn't seem like such a bad idea after all. Just kidding, just kidding. Paimon will still do her best, even if there are no snacks. And Paimon thought it smelled good while it was still in the oven! Oh, it's even better now. Paimon can't stop drooling. No, no. Being greedy is one thing, but Paimon knows how to count. Besides, Paimon knows that if she ate too many, then others wouldn't have enough. Wait, even you don't believe Paimon? How could you? Attention! Ace Detective Paimon has something to say! When the countdown started, Linny did indeed go into the tunnel. But he immediately used a vent to access the Opera House basement, which is where the underground core of the Oratrice is stored. Once he reached that area, he heard a voice in what should have been an empty room. Since he felt something was amiss, he returned immediately! The crime scene had already developed by the time he reached the tunnel again, and in order to complete the magic trick, he did not remain there for any length of time. Finally, he reached the surface, and that was when the accident happened from his point of view. Therefore, he's innocent! Whew! Paimon did it! Paimon actually managed to say all that! Wasn't it awesome?
In other words, you believe that he knew nothing of the incident?
That's right!
My reasoning?
If that's the case, then if Cowell hadn't entered the tunnel, who was the entire setup meant to kill? Assuming that what you say is true, Linny only needed to kidnap the young girl to cause a new disappearance case. What would the point of killing someone on stage be? That's right! Linny wasn't in the box or in the tunnel! That's why he didn't hear anything strange during the performance! This means that when the crime happened, Linny had already entered the basement via the vent. The same clue you used to disprove his alibi has now become the best proof! Ha ha! How do you like that? Ahem! It's Ace Detective Paimon's time to shine again! In the original plan, Cowell would tamper with the water tank rope, and the number selector securing his target. When the magic box containing Halsey was lowered, the metal hook would retract gradually and pierce the balloon at the top of the box. When the balloon attached to the box popped, the water from the primordial seed inside it would pour down and dissolve Halsey. Afterward, Cowell would enter the tunnel and break the flower vase to conceal the water inside the tunnel, with the remaining evidence being covered up by the water tank on stage. But he encountered something unexpected in the tunnel and wound up being fatally hit by the same water tank he meant to use to cover his tracks. And it's Ace Detective Paimon time! Having been selected out of the blue, Lillianne panicked. Her panic only intensified after she entered the tunnel and had water poured on her head. So she kicked the door open, producing the thud we all heard. Hearing the commotion, Cowell leapt into the tunnel, only to discover that Lillianne had not dissolved. He did not know that Lillian was not from Fontaine, but was a thief who made her way in by stealing a ticket. Mistakenly believing that the water from the primordial sea needed time to take effect, he tried to force Lillian back into the box. The two broke the flower vase during the struggle, but Lillian came out on top, knocking Cowl out and putting him in the box. With no way of escaping, she changed her clothes and hid in the costume trunk until the performance ended. She knew that she would have to go through guard inspection if she tried to leave afterward, so she has been trapped in the opera house these last 2 days.
She had already become desperately hungry by the time we were chatting over macarons. So, she swiped two of them right under our noses. Talk about a sneaky thief.
At this point, all the events that happened in the tunnel have now come to light.
As such, Linny and Lynette are officially declared not guilty.